What's going on, guys? Welcome back to another live stream on the channel. And today, obviously, we will be playing the server. So I'll be telling you what we're going to be doing in today's live stream, obviously. And yeah, so we're making this game, Slender. It's kind of a hard game. It's harder than any other game we've done before. Let me just have a look. Night Hunt, that's easy. It's just summoning mobs. Floor is lava, easy, just cloning and filling. Bounce is we just built it. Hello everyone that's joining. Gravity, it's just to reset the map. Murder mystery, I didn't build that one. Developer Theo did. Animal wipeout, that was pretty easy. Mob hunt. Oh wait, night hunt, I'm getting confused with the past updates because we changed Mob Hunt. Mob Hunt was called Night Hunt. It was called Mob Hunt because you're killing the mobs. And Night Hunt is where you're at night. So basically, Night Hunt, there was a few complications at first. Mob Hunt, slap a fish, quite easy. Anvil run, easy. Maze runner, completely easy. There's hardly any command blocks to do with that one. Anvil drop, that was a struggle. Block party, that's sometimes a struggle. Well, I think there's still some bugs with it now. Swim, that's easy. And four corners, that is absolutely terrible. We failed on that game. So, I don't know why I'm getting a block. Oh yeah, it's to get outside of this area. So, we're making Slender. There's no current command for creating Slender at the moment. So we are going to go over to a completely fresh area of the map that we have not explored before, because this game, we don't know if this is going to be laggy. So yeah, it's worth a try. So let's head over this way. I don't think we've explored over this way a bit much. So this is getting to around 1,000 minus 1,000. We want the map to be far enough away. The ice cream van's here.
Oh, that's nice.
Scared me then. I thought Minecraft had new music. So we'll go 1,000 blocks and see where this takes us. Then we'll just round the other number. Oh, we went too far. Okay, so 1,000 is here. And we'll go... we'll go this way to 350. You know, let's go 300. Alright, so 1,300. Okay. That should be easy coordinates to remember, right? Hopefully. One second. Just changing a few things. No, I won't be playing on the server games. We are just developing today until after the live stream. I'm just messaging a few developers because this game will be needing a bit of help. Alright, okay, let's start creating it. This game's going to be quite big, and we tend to have it dark. So let's go... what block should we use that's quite dark? We'll go spruce. I think that's one of the darkest blocks. Yeah, spruce is the darkest block. Wait, wood. What's this one? That's dark oak, but that's more of a grey. Actually, let's compare them. Now, if you have blindness, which will affect us, so affect AP blindness one. Ah, that's for 1 second. 100, one. Alright, so I think we'll go this one. This is spruce, yeah. We'll go spruce. Yeah, we'll definitely go that one. So we'll change this to clear. There we go. So we've got our chosen block, which is spruce. So we're presumably going to go spruce trees, right? Yeah, and we'll get some spruce leaves as well. Now we just got to make terrain. So this is going to be the middle of the map, right? So we're just going to build a pillar to mark the middle of the map. And yeah, right, we just got to build terrain now. So actually, that would be the spawning area, wouldn't it? I did have this all mapped out and stuff, but then I decided not to do it, and now I'm deciding to do it. So this is the spawning area. So let's just go like that, but not like that. My brother's online, brilliant. Nice to know. Blocks that blend in, that don't look, you know what, we'll go stone. Stone and chorus dirt. So we'll go get the stone. That's here. And chorus dirt is here. Well, if you guys didn't know, chorus dirt, when you place it, the dirt doesn't grow over it. It just remains as dirt. So what we can do is we can get our barrier block and make an outline for where we want to. People are messaging me on Snapchat. One second. Alright, okay, I'm back. So, what was I saying? I'm just going to continue about the chorus dirt. So chorus dirt, it's good for not growing grass, so you can just keep it as dirt. And because at this moment in time, when you're placing barrier blocks, it gets rid of the dirt, and it gets rid of the grass underneath it, so you can see the outlines. So it's good if we just have it a mixture for now. So we'll go like this. How many blocks was it? Two. One, two. And we'll go back up this way as well. We'll have to expand the stone this side, and we'll make it go uphill a bit. So it's like a proper stone, I guess. Like a huge boulder. We'll add some cobblestone onto it as well. So it like blends in and stuff. We're gonna have the map pretty big, but not too big. Well, yeah, not too big because you're gonna have blindness, but pretty big. Because the way I want this map to work is you spawn in and only one piece of, the way we could do it is only one piece of paper spawns in at a time. So when you collect one, it's gonna collect another one. I mean, when you collect one, that specific pressure plate is gonna disappear, and then you find another pressure plate that spawns in as soon as you press that pressure plate. It's kind of confusing, but I can do it. I know I can. And with the help of command block expert developers, I think we can do it as well. So we've got one developer that just likes to help out and just fill stuff in. The stuff that like takes too long. So if we was getting rid of dirt, making a hole, I'd make an outline. So let's say, imagine this was like 50 times bigger. I'd do an outline like that, and I'd say LPS, get rid of everything on the inside. And she'd do that. She'd just break it all by hand because she's not very good at using command blocks. We're slowly training her to use command blocks, but yeah, that takes time. And time isn't what we have when we are developing, because we like games to be quickly made. So players like you can have them. Right, so we'll do some spruce trees around. Oh, that's a bit close to the stone. We'll go here. No, here. That's a decent, that's a decent width apart. There we go. And then we'll do some terrain as well. It's not all going to be one level. We're going to be going up and down. So we'll do stuff like this. Should be fine. There we go. After this live stream, I'm most probably going to cut it down. Like, download it, cut it down, and re-upload it. Like, actually, we'll live stream every bit of the process of making this. Of making this game. Oh, we can have some caves as well. Sure. So the way Slender Man's going to work is you're going to have two books. One for we're going to have one book. One that gives you invisibility. And one that gives you speed. And then when you're not holding that book, you can see stuff. Actually, wait. Alright, so the reason why we're holding off on this development is because we haven't exactly planned it out, but the map's going to be quite big, so I think we'll have time to plan it out over time. So the way I'm thinking of having it is, instead of the players having blindness, I think Slenderman should have blindness and speed and invisibility. And the way you kill Slenderman basically is to collect all 8 pages. I know 8 is a lot, but it will start off over time with like 2 pages. Like when the game's first developed and stuff, it will have just 2 pages, and then we'll add more pages over time. Because once we've got the base coding set up, it shouldn't be that hard to finish off the game, surely. Okay. Let's go up a bit more here. There we go. Some more trees. Why are the trees not growing, you ask? Well, because I've got the tick speed set to 0, and when I want all the tree, if I'm happy with the tree placement, I'll put the trees all the way up to 40,000, 4,000, one of them, and it should instantly grow there and then. So, for example, I'll show you in a second what I mean. Got to do some more terrain here. We'll have some water as well. And I'm getting Snapchats left, right, and center. Never mind. It's just people sending their streaks. Because they can't do that any other time, can they? Right, so we've done enough going up. I want to go a bit down now. You can use this as a tutorial to build your own Slender Man game if you want to. Alright, we can add a bit of chorus there as well. Just to make it outline, I guess. I know you're not exactly going to be able to see this part of the map, but it's nice to have. Just in case you manage to get out, because I know people are good at that these days. They will find any way of getting out. That's why I don't want to spoil too much, but we've started developing the 10.0 lobby. It's going to be super, super big, and we're planning on not having any exploits to get outside the map. So the barrier system is going to be 1,000, maybe 2,000 blocks big. I know that sounds like a lot, but trust me, it's not when you when it comes to developing. You've dealt with bigger command blocks, I swear. Right, so let's get a bit of water. I think this is looking a bit dry, and my TV is powering off. Power off plus any key to cancel. Cancel, thank you very much. I do not need you in my life. Right, let's get a bit of water. And let's build like a little pond area. Actually, I'm thinking of just having a lobby for Slenderman, because we can have different maps. So if we make this a lobby first, because we're not that too far into development to go back. I mean, we can go back at any time, but the further along development we are, the harder it is to go back. If you get what I mean. If you don't, just leave a message and I'll explain it more. So yeah, let's set it tonight. I know some of you people won't be able to see it that well, but we will be adding some torches and stuff as well. So we'll do / game rule random tick speed 4,000. And all the trees should grow with a click of a finger. Oh yeah, it's supposed to be day when they grow. Okay, so the game decided to customize it a bit and add a mushroom, apparently. If we've added mushrooms onto Minecraft. I didn't plan on adding a mushroom, but sure, we can add. Actually, yeah, that's not a bad idea. We'll add some mushrooms into the game. Mushrooms grow on pod soil and in the dark. That's going to be a problem. It really is. Okay, so I believe we have the map. Well, this is going to be the lobby, so I believe this is big enough, so we can just spam trees now. And they should just grow instantly. Sorry for the weird noise. So we've done half the lobby. But at the moment, yeah. Let's add a tree onto these little pod things. So once you're inside of the thing, can you see what's going on from the distance if it's time? Yes, you can. That would be a problem because we don't want to see, if you look closely, you can see where the world just infinitely goes. So like over there, you can just see the grass just going and going and going and going. You can see that over here as well through the trees, which we don't want. So maybe we can add a bit of grass. Like tall grass and stuff. So let's get bone meal. Replace it with, let's replace it with spruce wood. And let's place down the, this is going to be too laggy. Let's change it to back to zero. And let's just spam a load of grass around. Hopefully this should make it so you can't exactly see through well enough. Okay, let's have a look. It's going to be a bit different looking in the day, but you can see the sky as well, so that helps us a bit. Which, yeah, you can see here, just above my crosshair, the sky. We don't want to see the sky. Oh my god. Alright, one of the developers are watching me. Which, hello developer, how are you doing today? Feel free to send messages in the chat. Not message us on Discord. And maybe you can add a few suggestions as well for what you might add. But yeah, Okay, so you can see over there, you can see the terrain, and you can slightly see through that tree there, can't you? We don't want that. We do not want that. So we want to keep building enough. We want to keep building out enough so you can't see a thing. Alright, that should be enough. No, we'll add a few more trees here. There we go. Any trees needed around here? No. Oh, here. Alright, that should be good enough. It's starting to get hot in here. Let's open the window a bit. Okay. Might be because I'm wearing a jumper, I'm not too sure. I'm thinking of buying a face cam thing soon. So we can, like, so you guys can see me and stuff. Okay. What else should we add? Oh yeah, we're gonna add like little leaves. So let's get jungle leaves to add a bit of color into the lobby. Because we don't want it all looking the same. So just jungle leaves to make it look like bushes and stuff. Because this is Slender Man. This game's called Slender. What? I swear I just placed them. I'm gonna have a look on the live stream. Add a bit more stones in the background as well. Make this game look super scary, because that is the aim of. We'll add some more over here as well. And over there, that looks empty, so we'll add a few more vines over there as well. More leaves, we need more leaves. Just literally spam as much down as we can. So if you're here, we want it so you can see a cave. So let's go with a cave down here. Not too far though, because that's not necessary. We'll go with chorus dirt, because it's a cave. We wanted to make it look like someone's dig down to survive and stuff. Because it's like a survival thing now. And just twist off here so no one can see in. And there we go. There we go, we've got a little cave. Now let's see what it looks like in at night time. So midnight, that looks a lot better. That really does. Over there looks a bit bland. But everywhere else here looks completely fine. It's what I've wanted. Okay, let's change it back to day. Actually, no, we'll keep it at night. Sorry for the spam. And we'll add a bit of color, I mean lights into it. So, what light sources do we have? If we get the ender chest. So this is our vault. This is the vault altogether. Chemistry, we'll go with chemistry items. See what we have here to deal with. We have blue torches, green torches, purple torches, red torches, and underwater torches. Most of you people that keep joining the world, they're like, no, you don't have custom torches and stuff. No, we don't have custom torches. This is already in the game. But you can get red torches as well. Have you noticed it's not redstone torches? It's just red torches. And it's completely different. If I get some red torches and some redstone torches, you can see the difference in texture. So, and then that. See the difference? Yeah. Let's place this back down. Chemistry items. Got some balloons. Oh, we don't have a red balloon. That's annoying. We'll go with go with underwater torches because they give out a white source. And we could just pick these up as well now. And we'll place one here. Yeah, that seems fine. Actually, no. I don't want that. We want it a bit murky, so instead let's go for pickles. So, a sea pickle. And we're going to need water as well, so... water. And let's place the water here. Ender chest. Ah, I hate it when you can't actually get a block to fill it in. Nope, too bright. Go 2. Brightness of 2 should be fine. There we go. Completely forgot that my microphone was off, so I've literally just said to you that you can change the best light source is that pickle, because you can change the brightness of it. I know it's not much, but you can still change it. So yeah, I think this is about it for now for this side of the lobby. I'm gonna go get a drink and then I'll be right back for the next part of the lobby. So, see you guys in a second. Actually, the next part of the lobby is quite interesting because we'll be doing like different boards and stuff, so that's the part you want to be staying out for. So I shall see you guys in a second. See you. Alright, and I am back. So, like I said, we're going to get into the second part of the developing for the lobby of this game. And this second part's going to be containing signs of the map, how to play, and maps. Oh, wait, no. Developers that help make the maps, how to play, and maps. So, maps will be in the middle. Developers this side and thingy this side. You know what I said. Alright, so actually this kind of suits the updated theme, like for the update 10.0, kind of suits the map type. I'm just gonna say one thing, no more spoilers after this. It is super, super, super big. That's all I'm gonna say. Okay, so you spawn here. Let's expand it out a bit. So two and then one. That's what we're gonna have to remember. So, one, two, one. Get rid of these. And then we will, we'll do 1, 2, and then 1, 2, 3, 1, and then 1, 2, 3, and then, actually instead of 3 we'll go 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, and then like that. Okay, I think that seems fine and fair, because I don't think people are going to be running too far off, because they should already know, like, the only places you need to be is just here. So we'll do the same. So 2, then 1, 2, 3, that's 4, and then we'll go 1, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then 1, 2, 3, 1, 1, 2, 3, and then like this. So, literally, we can just build off of the structure of this. So, we're gonna need some. Well, let's go with acacia. Acacia. I can't wait for the boa boa trees to be introduced, because they seem interesting. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2, 3. Now, this doesn't look interesting at all, but if you add things onto it, so like from behind and on the front, it seems interesting then. Oh, that's close to the border, it really is. We'll add this and this on top. Oh, we can have a little creepy house that you can see off to in the distance. The creepy house can have like a body of a slender on it or something. So, yeah, we could do that. Actually, where's the... This is the middle. We know that. So we're going to base it off the middle point. So the middle is going to start around here. So instead of it being one block wide, we'll go two blocks wide. Sorry, bro, you're going to have to move. You're going to have to move over a few. So it can be like that. Oh, that seems a bit wide on one side, does it? Is it wide on one side? 1, 2, 1, 2. No, it's not. Okay, so we're fine. And then 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. 1, 2, 3. 1, 2. And then we'll go 1. Add the stairs on top. This doesn't look professional, but it will have to do. Actually, yeah, we can have it there, and then we can go over here and build the other two. And then you're not exactly running off too far, are you? I don't think you are. So we'll go here. Actually, no, here, and 1, 2, 3, and here. And then we'll do the same for this side as well. So here and here. Is that the same distance apart? It is, by coincidence. An area, actually? I think I might have, actually, yeah. Yeah, I did. Needs to be one more. Okay. Boom, 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 boom. Oh no, we got rid of this one by accident. I assume it was by accident. I don't remember if I even placed it, to be honest. And 1-2, 1-2, up 1, 1-2. Alright. That's the boards done. We just need to fill them in and add the signs. So that's the maps, that's developers, and that's how to play. Patted down areas of like graph paths and stuff. There we go. Seems fine, I suggest. I assume it's fine. Let's have a look from inside the lobby. Yeah, that's fine. But how about we get some hoe? Let's get a hoe. That's not how you spell hoe. That's how. And let's also add some of that stuff as well. So then like boom, boom, boom. That doesn't seem too bad, actually. That doesn't seem too bad. Quite like that. Why are we still building in the dark? Set it today. There we go. That looks a lot better. They're going to decide if they want to join. No, I didn't. Jeez. Okay. Let's fit on with... Out. Birch will stand out a lot. So, on here we could do... Maps, and then we want it to be a dark color. So, let's go 8. 8's a dark color, yeah. We don't know what maps are going to be introduced yet, as of yet. Developer Theo, bonjour, ça va, je me parle Tyler. This is going to be developers. What should we have it for this? We should have 5. Let's go with 5. And we'll do... No, that's too bright. Let's go... Making the scenery now. This map's practically done now. Like, actually, no, it's not. Just add like weird shovel path things. There we go. Off into the distance, I'm starting to get messages. Am I one of the developers of the map? No, you're not. You're not a developer at the moment, because you haven't, I mean for this map, because you haven't actually helped develop it, so you won't be on the development board. But you can give like screenshots and stuff and what to add into the map, then I may consider putting you on. You never know. Beyond is where we need to be. I keep building. And then after this hill, we just have to do the decoration bit. Okay, so let's put this in my inventory, get rid of this. Trees, leaves, and bone meal. Oh wait, no, chorus dirt as well. Chorus dirt, grass path, leaves, vines, water, maybe not. that seems to be it at the moment. Right, let's start building. A Minecraft beta has came out the other day. Oh, I forgot he's just joined, hasn't he? He's not gonna know where we are. There we go. Thanks, just sorting stuff out for school. Alright, okay. Getting private messages from Discord from one of our other developers. If you want to become a developer, join our Discord down below. And join the Discord. And then it's just simply go that putting that code into Discord and you should be able to join. And then there's a section called Apply for Developer. You'll be and apply. One of the minimum requirements is for you to have at least played the server once within the last 2 weeks. Because if you haven't played the server once within the last 2 weeks, then we'll have a few problems. Because then we'll just think that you're actually just applying for developer and you're not actually developing. And there's no coding stuff required. You don't need to know coding. LPS, one of our developers, don't know coding, and she's doing fine, she's just a builder. But if you do have good experience using command blocks, that would be a big plus as well. So we could do more with more people, especially people that don't mess up on the command blocks like me and Theo. Sometimes we mess up, not all the time by the way. But if we didn't know any command blocks, like any code at all for command blocks, we won't be doing this map and Block Party would sure not exist. Let's add a bit of a hill here. And then more trees. Trees, beautiful trees. And then we just need bone meal. Seems a bit empty over here. There we go. Let's put tree here, tree here, here, and 22 other places into this world as well. Hey, this is the link to join the Discord. Physics6XUM7F. That is the code, and I would know if it gets deleted because I'm the one that has to delete it. Oh, so sensitive these days. There we go. I think that should be enough. Let's change the speed to 4,000. Yeah, obviously we'll add on how we are developing in the game and stuff. So, yeah.